Zulu was probably the most important movie in my career because it gave me a chance to play a proper character. Up until that time, I'd been playing little bit parts in movies.
Zulu is the one I could see over and over, and that was your first real film part. I don't even know if you think it was any good. Something about that movie really got me.
Well, Zulu was okay, but the trouble was it was about the... it wasn't much of a success in America because it was about the wars, the colonial wars, the British Army and the Zulus, you know. And there's a lot of time it was black and white people slaughtering each other. Yeah. By the time we got to America, nobody really wanted to know anything. It wasn't a great idea. The only thing is that I would say, in its defense, it was purely, from a British point of view, it was just about two armies fighting each other, and it was made in complete innocence.
I didn't think it
had... And as you're very tall...
I didn't think it had... What part of Africa does the Zulu come from?
Northern South Africa. There's in the north of South Africa, there's a land which is all mountains, and the Zulus are farmers, and they're hill people. They're very big, tall men, and... the Basutos are the people from the flatland who are little men. Yeah. I don't know why that is. I suppose you have to get tall to see over the hills if you live in the mountains.
Yeah. I just liked it as an adventure movie. I mean,
well,
I didn't see it.
It's a great adventure movie, but and I was rather sort of shocked at the reaction in America of say, for instance, people like Dick Gregory did a whole skit on it, you know, and which sort of ridiculed it. And it hadn't occurred to anybody in England about color prejudice or anything. It was just the British Army has fought and lost to every army in the world. We didn't figure it was any difference to fight and lose to the Zulus.
Had trouble everywhere else.
We had trouble. We got a few. Yeah, we've even got some now.
Yeah.
Zulu launched Michael Caine, but it didn't make him a millionaire.
Quite impoverished. I'd made Zulu, but I got paid £4,000 for Zulu.
Stanley Baker, the actor he had met on a hill in Korea, arranged for Michael to meet producer Cy Endfield, who had a big project.
The screen test was actually terrible. And I think most screen tests are. All you do is photograph somebody's fear. You don't photograph their talent. And anyway, that was done on a Friday. And on a Saturday night, I went to a party. And quite by coincidence, Cy Endfield was there. And I thought, well, have I got the part or not? And he came in and he just said, good evening, and walked by. And my eyes followed him all around the room, waiting for him to say something, at least say, you haven't got the part. And he finally, he came up to me, and he said, you did yesterday probably the worst screen test I've ever seen in my life. He said, Stanley Baker and I may be mad, but we're going to give you the part.
It was Zulu. Caine looked the part of the English gentleman soldier, but there was still the issue of that accent.
I was nervous when I first did it, because your first film is always the most nerve-wracking. I could probably do it better now. I remember Cy Endfield, when he did the first take, said, cut halfway through, the very first take, and he said, Michael, he said, your voice has gone up about 3 octaves. And my voice was up here with nerves, and they could hardly record it, and we had to start again, and then I brought my voice down. But what had happened was, is everybody had come out of all the production offices because they were sure this Cockney couldn't speak like that. And I was sitting on this horse and I suddenly turned around and there was the entire crew, office people, staff, producers, everybody, who had never been on the set before, just standing there staring at me. And I was sitting on this horse and this is what threw me for the first take.
Bromhead, 24. That's my post, up there.
And nothing has ever thrown me on a take since. And I'm sure never will. Lamps fall over and I still keep going straight through it. Because I think I'm in live television and no matter what happens, you've got to keep going till the end.
Just like his screen character, Michael Caine the actor was transformed in Zulu. This was his big break.